Instagram. What a pleasure to be back with you for a live session today. And today's session is an extraordinary session. It is a session which will move you all. It is going to be a terrific session, a session which is very close to my heart, very emotional. If after today's session, if you don't have a tear in your eye and a passion in your heart, then you are not made of the stuff that the armed forces look for. Today will be a different session. Today is 21st June 2021, Monday. But I purposely chosen it to be a totally different kind of a session. Okay? Jai Hind all of you. Jai Hind. Jai Hind, Jai Hind. Ankit, Jai Hind. Knock-knee is not much of a problem, don't worry. Happy yoga day, yeah, today is a yoga day. But the kind of pictures I see don't enthuse me much. So, today is a special day where we will discuss a life story of a hero, a real hero of India. And his story I will share with you. And I have a big surprise for you all. I have a huge surprise for you all. The surprise is you will have a guest who has never come live. Never come live. She is child of this country. A child of destiny. Usko hum leke aayenge. I don't want to, abhi main bata nahi raha hu kaun aa raha hai. But you'll have to wait. Okay. The moment we cross 100, we'll start the session. And this session is on Major Padmapani Acharya Mahavir Chakra. Today is his birthday. He would have been 53 years old today. I will tell you about his story, about his life. And you will come to know ki if he could have reached here, got a Mahavir Chakra and hero of Dras, we broke the back of Pakistani insurgents, Pakistani army in Kargil war after two Rajrif, which broke the defenses of Tololing. Tololing, those of you who have been, I Colonel Sunil Prem, big salute. Tololing is just, it is seen from the memorial in Kargil, if you know. It's just there. So the entire ridgeline was occupied by Pakistani regulars. And the responsibility was given to two Rajrif under Colonel Ravindranath Veer Chakra. He and his unit, they broke the back. Uske baad, things became much easier for the other units, which, you know, got involved in capturing and taking back our territory. But it was done by two Rajrif at great cost. Four officers killed in action, Mahavir Chakras. Two JCOs, 17 other ranks. Char officer, two JCOs, 17 other ranks killed in action in the Battle of Tololing in Dras sector. And over 90 wounded. So, kuch palton mein kuch dam chahiye ye kaam karne ke liye. Aur ye bahut behtareen unit hai. And I will show you a cap which this unit has gifted me when I visited, when they came. I brought them back to Tololing when I was, GOC in Leh 2 years back, and I was organizing this event. So, I said, inko unit ko bulaya jaye wahan. So, inka ek young officer aur puri team aaye wapas. And Vikram Batra ki bhi ek din baat karenge. But today, I want you all to concentrate on this man. Major Padmapani Acharya Mahavir Chakra. Iski life ka jab aap sunoge, you will be surprised. He is from two Rajrif. Rajputana Rifles, which basically has Rajputs, Jats, Gujars, Ahirs and lot of Muslim troops. Theek hai, ye Rajputana Rifles mein ye communities ka samavesh hota hai. Quite like my unit, First Guard, Second Punjab. So we are at 100 now. So I will start the session. You will give me that cap of two Rajrif upar. So we'll start story of Major Padmapani Acharya Mahavir Chakra. His life, how did he how did he become an officer in the army? What he did as a child? To tell you ki aap log mein se poochte rehte ho, this is the cap of two Rajrif. 20th Kargil Vijay Divas, Tololing Battalion. This is my prized possession, you know. This cap is my prize possession. So this is one of my favorite caps, two Rajarif cap. Yes, Vijayan Thapar, Vivek Gupta, and of course Kangaroos, Lieutenant Kangaroos, who climbed without jungle shoes, nange pair chad gaya wo, and of course Padmapani Acharya. So what we will do is, I will tell you about the story of Padmapani Acharya, and then we will get Aparajita. Aparajita means who can't be defeated. Aparajita is his daughter. She was born 3 months after Major Padmapani Acharya was killed in action in the Battle of Tololo. His wife was pregnant with Aparajita, and the letters which Major Acharya Archie wrote to his father, to his mother, to his wife, wo letters is kitab ke andar hain. And those letters were read by Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee. One of the letters was read by the Prime Minister in the Parliament. Armed Forces ki laal rang ki chitthi mein unhone ek chitthi likhi. Bahut si chitthiyan likhi hain. Bahut hi zabardast haisiyat ke insaan hain. Bahut hi zabardast haisiyat ke insaan. But aise aise hero hain. So main aapko na, I will share his story with you, and then I will try to get Aparajita as and when she comes. Today I called her up to tell her, beta, you must come live today because we are going to discuss your father's story. So Major Acharya was born on 21st of June 1968. His father was a wing commander in Air Force, and his mother, of course, she was there. And he was born in Odisha, and he studied in Kendra Vidyalayas all over. Jahan jahan father ki posting hoti rahi, father Air Force mein the, wahan wahan Acharya ki bhi jo hai, and there were four brothers and sisters. Theek hai? To Major Acharya jo hai, bachpan se hi bahut shaitan, bahut hi, sare kaam karne, and he was very, acha, Aparajita is here, I'll just get her. Aparajita, you must ping me to, waiting for you. Okay, where is Aparajita? I'll have to search for her. 1 minute. Aparajita. I've got Aparajita here. Aparajita Acharya, proud daughter of such a great hero, whom never. Hi, Aparajita, beta, how are you?
Good evening, sir. How are you?
What a pleasure to see you.
I've been watching it right from the start, and thank you so much. It was such a beautiful introduction.
Yeah, we are connected in some way. The way we met in Leh, and that program we had in the Leh airfield, Leh stadium, where Ricky Cage performed for us.
I must tell everybody, I was hosted in Delhi, I was hosted in Leh, I was hosted in Kargil, but nowhere was I hosted and treated the way Mohr Uncle treated me, and it was absolutely the best experience. And your humility and your greatness, I mean, you're such an inspiration to me.
Thank you. We have remained in touch since that day. Isn't it?
Absolutely.
Yeah, yes. And I'm going to follow your life, okay, all throughout.
Of course, I'm not going to stop being in touch with you, Uncle.
So, friends, Aparajita is here with you. She's the daughter of destiny, okay? And I must tell you, pehle main will talk of, you just keep interjecting. This book has been created by her for her father. This is a coffee table book. Later on, you must share a link so that people can get this book and get inspired.
Absolutely. Anna,
so Major Acharya was born on 21st June 1968 in a normal middle class family. Father was an Air Force officer, mother was a homemaker, and from the beginning he was interested in mouth organ, into music, playing tabla, and he became an actor. Unko matlab extracurricular activities ka bahut shauk tha. ठीक है, पूरे उल्टे काम करना, बदमाशियां करना. ही वॉज अ हैप्पी चाइल्ड, वेरी हैप्पी चाइल्ड. उन्होंने केवी से एजुकेशन करी ऑल ओवर द कंट्री, ऑल केंद्रीय विद्यालय लाइक मेनी ऑफ यू, आर्मी स्कूल, केवी, ये सब बच्चे पेरेंट्स के साथ जा रहे हैं एक जगह से दूसरी जगह. ही डिड दैट आफ्टर 12 ही ज्वाइंड इंडियन होटल इंडियन इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ होटल मैनेजमेंट भुवनेश्वर, इजंट इट? या सो ही वांटेड टू ज्वाइन द होटल इंडस्ट्री. ठीक है, वहां आई हैव सीन हिज पिक्चर्स वेयरिंग द यू नो कैप एंड एप्रन एंड ही वाज टोपी, वो बड़ी वाली जो टोपी है वो एंड एप्रन एंड हॉस्पिटैलिटी इंडस्ट्री में दैट इज वेयर ही वांटेड टू गो एंड ही वाज अ लाइव वायर इन हिज क्लास, यू नो लाइव वायर इन हिज क्लास बिकॉज ही वाज वेरी गुड एट एक्टिंग, फुल ऑफ लाइफ, लाइवली पर्सन. तो वहां से उन्होंने अपना ग्रेजुएशन किया होटल मैनेजमेंट के अंदर एंड ही पिक्ड अप अ जॉब इन द होटल इंडस्ट्री. Then one day he met an uncle who told him, यार इतना लंबा चौड़ा आदमी है तू, इतना फिट, इतना स्मार्ट आदमी है, why don't you join the army? Army is the place for you to go. So very late in his life, you know, he was already working.
24.
When he decided.
One attempt left.
One attempt.
24, imagine. That was his only attempt.
He had only one attempt left. He realized this very late. मतलब last attempt था short service commission का. And he took this call, he came home and told his father, Dad, I am going to join the army. Generally, people want to join army at 20, 21, 22. I joined little later, mujhe laga ki yaar hum to late aaye at 21. And he joined at 24 plus last chance. So he went for SSB and Bhopal was his board and he got selected in his first chance. Theek hai? To wahan se unhone apne parents ko bataya, he joined the OTA and in 1993 he got commissioned in August batch of OTA and there are very good pictures of his in officers training academy enjoying his training and all, and his he was identified as a very good cadet, you know, his officer like qualities, his joyfulness, his passion, he was very patriotic, bahut passion tha, and he got commissioned into 2 Rajrif, one of the finest units. You heard of this unit, history has been written by this unit by in Tololeng, aur ye aisa mauka unit ko 100 200 saal mein milta hai, 100 200 saal mein mauka milta hai desh ke liye ladai ladne ka aur ye kaam karne ka, 2 Rajrif ko mauka mila under Colonel Ravindranath. And the best part is that when he was fighting the war, you know, the letters he wrote, today I was reading his letters again and this letters form, they are in this book. Every time I read these letters, you know, I read these letters written by him. See his handwriting, you know. And the best part is the letters are written to his mother, to his father, and to his wife. And her letter mein unhone jo baat kahi jo pradhanmantri ne Lok Sabha mein padha inka chitthi jo unhone father ko likha tha ki my wife is pregnant. And she should be listening to or reading Gita, because Gita is a great granth. Because the guy, boy or a girl, whoever is born, must be born with very good Indian values. So Aparajita was learning Gita, and itni matlab touching stories hain is in letters ke andar, ek ek letter ke andar. In fact, this is a collector's item, you know, and I hold it very close to my chest because Aparajita has gifted me this book. और इनका ऑटोग्राफ भी लिया मैंने, देखो. सो एंड इन द वॉर, व्हेन इज इन द वॉर, यू नो 29th जून इज हिज मार्टिरडम डे, व्हेन ही इन कैप्चर ऑफ दैट ऑब्जेक्टिव ही गॉट ग्रेनेड ब्लास्ट, ही डिडंट वरी, ही कंटिन्यूड, हिज यूनिट कैप्चर्ड द फीचर, हिज कंपनी, यू नो इट वाज ऑल ऑफिसर लेड, इट वाज ऑल ऑफिसर लेड ऑपरेशंस. And, you know, he didn't survive that, this thing. But till the last day, he was writing letters to his father, to his mother, and to his wife. And each letter was speaking of the privilege of being an Indian Army officer. Ek baar kahi dar, kahi sanchay, kahi marne ka ghabrahat, kuch bhi nahi tha. And tab tak, one of their officers had already been killed in action. And he mentions in that letter.
तो ये बंदे ऐसे या
only when Vivek Gupta uncle's news of his martyrdom had come on TV, only then we knew he was at war. He never told us he was at war until then. So he
and
did not
Vivek Gupta
probably
was
want
a
the family
mechanized
to
infantry
curry.
officer. Yeah, and he was a mechanized infantry officer doing attachment with Rajarif. So, proud son of Odisha, proud son of India. मैं इसीलिए बात करता हूँ, मेरे मेरे हर सेशन में बात करता हूँ यार, स्टेट की रिलीजन की बात मत किया करो यार, हम बहुत इस चीज से ऊपर हैं यार, प्लीज. आई हैव सीन मुस्लिम्स क्रिश्चियंस, क्या कम्युनिटी है यार, मतलब हम तो ऐसे ही बिना काम में लोगों को ना कलर देने के चक्कर में रहते हैं यार. नो, ग्रेट सन्स ऑफ इंडिया, एवरीबॉडी इज अ ग्रेट सन, ग्रेट डॉटर्स ऑफ इंडिया. सो ही अटेंड दिस मार्टिरडम एंड हिज हिज यू नो बॉडी लाइक अ हीरो वाज ब्रॉट टू हैदराबाद. द गवर्नर, द डिफेंस मिनिस्टर, Chief Minister Chandrababu Naidu, with his entire cabinet, was there. And, we have seen it. This is the first war that came to our drawing rooms, Kargil War, thanks to the media. It was brought to our drawing rooms. And hats off to the Prime Minister, the Chief of Army Staff, General VP Malik, the Prime Minister of the country. मतलब मैंने इतना जज्बा, इतना जोश अपने देश के अंदर बहुत कम देखा. आज के हालात देखो तो बड़ा अफसोस होता है कि हम एक दूसरे को चीर फाड़ करने के लिए तैयार है, लेकिन उस टाइम पे जब देश के ऊपर विपदा आई, व्हेन द सिचुएशन वाज सो क्रिटिकल, द होल कंट्री वाज टुगेदर एंड ही वाज गिवन अ ग्रेट ग्रेट दिस थिंग. बट एवरीबॉडी वाज वरीड अबाउट अपराजिता, वाज नॉट येट बॉर्न, शी वाज बॉर्न ऑन 14 सितंबर. ओके, 14 सितंबर 99, 3 months आफ्टर हर फादर हैड सैक्रिफाइज हिज लाइफ फॉर द नेशन. So this is the story of a normal officer, a school boy, goes to Indian Hotel Management Institute, does hotel management, goes to OTA in the last chance, does very well in OTA, joins the infantry unit, gets married at 27 years of age and sacrifices life at 31 years of age. And what a legacy has he left. Today he would have been 53 years old. प्राजिता भी आप बात करो, मैंने तो मतलब आई कांट स्पीक एनीथिंग मोर अबाउट इट.
थैंक यू सो मच, आई थिंक यू समराइज्ड इट सो ब्यूटीफुली. आई मीन आई वाज सिटिंग हियर एंड आई डोंट थिंक आई कुड हैव पुट इट इन अ बेटर वे मायसेल्फ, एंड आई वाज राइट फ्रॉम द स्टार्टिंग. यू हैव दिस वे ऑफ टॉकिंग दैट इज सो कैप्टिवेटिंग. व्हेन यू वर सेइंग सम ऑफ द थिंग्स, द स्मॉल स्मॉल थिंग्स दैट आई लुक एट हिम एंड आई लर्न, द वे ही हेल्ड ऑन टू फैमिली. Now he's at war. He has this role as a company commander, as a soldier, as a leader, as an officer. Yet he is writing letters back home, doing his job, looking out for his family as a son, as a husband, as a brother. He is, not wanting them to worry. There is optimism. He is writing in his letters, you all should visit the mountains sometime. There is bloodshed in that mountains. But him optimistically telling the family that where I am is very, it's okay, don't worry. It's all right. I'm at a great place. मिले होंगे वो 10 मिनट कुछ 2 दिन में, and to just pen it down the way that he does, I think that takes a lot of clarity and playing multiple roles at one point of time, not making an excuse. हम तो कॉलेज में होके बोल भी देते हैं यार कल घर कॉल करेंगे, असाइनमेंट है आज, but not making an excuse. Second, he lived his life to the fullest. It's not glamorous planning that makes a hero always. You can smallest things inspire you. He took that decision, he went with it, and he worked hard, even though he knew that the time was limited. He could have made an excuse about it, but he did not, and that's what I admire, that there was this ability ki nahi karna hai. His friend once asked him, "Fauj kyun join karni?" He said, "Two things, I want to kill the enemy, and I want to lead the contingent in RD parade."
I forgot to say this, Aprajita, there's a picture of his, this is amazing, yeah, good, I don't know how I got carried away. And I forgot to show you a picture of his leading the Republic Day contingent at the Rajpath. This is, you see him with the sword. This is his picture in the Republic Day. He led the contingent, and let me tell you, mostly it is officers from NDA who are very good in drill and who are leading. It's a rare for a short service officer to be so fit, so smart, so dashing. या राजरिफ की अगर आपने परेड लीड करनी है तो यू टू बी 6 फुट, जवानों के बराबर होना है, ऑफिसर ने पगड़ी बांधनी और मुछे भी वैसे होनी
चाहिए.
फॉर ऑल प्रैक्टिकल पर्पसेस ही वॉज नॉट अ उड़िया और एनीथिंग एल्स, ही वॉज अ राजरिफ बॉय, ही हैड बिकम अ सोल्जर ऑफ राजरिफ.
Uncle, you know, he just joked one saying ki I'm the Prince of Barmer, and till today some of the men actually believe, and they actually believe that he was the Prince of Barmer. He just joked about it because of his mustache and all, and till today some of them believe it. So some of his, he had that spirit in him. Some of the things I admire about him, when he spoke of Arjuna, when he spoke about the quality of learning, he learned so much. You see his letters, there is humor, there is a bit of political commentary, there is a bit, little bit of ye kya chal raha hai, wo kya chal raha hai. That is awareness. And second, his ability to put it in words. And it's just like Arjuna, right? He was learning, learning, learning. The whole Bhagavad Gita is him learning, allowing Krishna to teach him. Mm. Not presuming ki I am the best at everything I do, hence I have nothing to learn. There is always so much to learn. And that is one quality I admire so much in him. And his codename in war was Arjuna. I mean, it was destiny meant to play the way that it did.
He was a child of destiny. Nahi to kaha hotel management se last chance mein aana, that call, you know, ki somebody pushing him. Ki ye kaha reh gaya, isko to fauj mein leke aana chahiye tha. You know, and he joins such a great unit, and the unit is tasked for the capture of Tololing, the first feature, the first, very first feature, which broke the back of the Pakistani operations in Kargil. So these are all, you know, destiny plays a big role. But he has amazing qualities. And what why I'm getting a session like this is ki most of us have these qualities. We are all ordinary people. अरे ये कोई फिल्म की कहानी नहीं है, ये बॉलीवुड का आमिर खान और सलमान खान नहीं रोल प्ले कर रहे हैं, ये बिल्कुल ऑर्डिनरी लोग हैं ना, हमारे घरों में हैं ये बच्चे, आप लोगों में सब में ये क्वालिटी है.
It is absolutely, the intention of the book was also to tell, nobody is born a hero. Nobody does heroic acts from childhood and builds up to being somebody great. It's in that minute the decision you take. In that very moment the decision you take, that is what makes you. Sometimes we are not willing to take this opportunity when it comes, when it hits you right there. Sometimes our opportunities and commitments kind of come in together, and then we think we have to make a choice. But if only we are able to handle both at the same time, there is so much more that awaits us. I think about
Absolutely.
And I always say so much more than...
I've got Lieutenant Commander Vijay Nair, a great passionate guy. I requested him when we decided ki let's do a live. I said, Vijay, you must join this and meet Aparajita and take part in this, this discussion of this great hero of India.
Yes, sir. In fact,
Vijay. Aparajita.
Hi. How are you? How are you, Aparajita?
I'm so good, Uncle. We had planned to have a talk and look, really? Destiny. What I a know, beautiful day.
Destiny.
We had spoken about it. It did not work out somehow with the dates. And now look, I mean, it's, thank you so much for coming here. I'm so fortunate to have you on this live and be talking to you.
And see, we are celebrating his life.
We spoke so... Yes, in fact, we spoke last year. I think we spoke half an hour plus, you know, that day. I remember.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you for inviting. In fact, I left everything. And then, knowing that Aparajita is here.
And this is the Rajiv cap.
Oh, kya baat hai, sir.
Rajiv which was given to me by the unit. I got the unit, you know, when I was in Leh, when Aparajita first time came to Leh. 2 years back, so we got a contingent of this unit was in Rajasthan, and there's so much of issues. कैसे आएंगे, पहाड़ से आएंगे, जहाज से आएंगे. मैंने कहा यार तुम आ जाओ, please आ जाओ तुम्हारे. So young soldiers, there was only one JCO who was part of the war. Rest all there was a lieutenant, and I think 10 or 12 young soldiers. They came, they went up to Tololing, and they brought this cap with 2 stars for me, which I wear with a lot of pride, you know.
Seriously, sir. Such beautiful, this thing.
Such great memories.
It is.
Yeah, Prajita, tell us about your father much more. Yeah.
And I think the best part about him is relatability. I think people think that heroes have to be flawless in every aspect, hence they cannot relate to them. People have their own flaws and their own journeys. And also one other aspect of my father was, while he loved his job, he had an identity separate from the job. As in, his identity was about learning, doing so many things. Sometimes people confuse their identity with what they do. You can be absolutely 100% dedicated at what you do, but still have a personality outside it. So that one aspect of your life doesn't cloud everything else that you do. I think that's such an excellent quality that he had of leadership that way too. That clarity of thought.
Absolutely. You know, many ways when I was reading his letters today, you know, I have a box full of letters written by me to my father. My mother was illiterate. She could not read. She knew a little bit only. And to my wife, and almost similar circumstances. I was in Punch. And those letters, when my wife was carrying her son, and I was there. And those letters are written at 2 o'clock at night, at 3 in the morning, at 4 in the morning. And each time, date ke niche is to write time. My handwriting is not as good as his. But 4 to 5 pages, in spite of being under intense counter, you know, on the line of control, found time to write exactly the way he has written, on army, on life, of fun. I think soldiers have a lot of things in common.
That is so wonderful. When people talk of letters, I mean, that time of handwritten letters is gone, and it's so beautiful because they have a way of their own. And do you know something, Uncle? My father had bad handwriting. He worked on his handwriting. I did not know this. They told me that, you know, he worked on his handwriting. When he realized it was bad, I don't know who told him, but he actually sat down over days, practiced writing every day, and made his handwriting that good. So he worked on his flaws.
Yeah, he was a meticulous person, and he was very good in communication skills. He was a master of ceremony in most of the events. So he endeared to his friends, his colleagues, his troops and all. I think everybody loved him. He was that kind of a person who cultivated those, you know, qualities in him. And that is what we keep telling Vijay and self all the time. Ki yaar, ye leadership na, many of these attributes can be cultivated as we go along. Kyo, Vijay?
Yes, sir. I mean, in fact, I have read about sir, and you know, it was such a privilege to read about him. Such an awesome guy. And, you know, that wo jo bolte na sir, wo kut kut ke bhara hai in his daughter,
rather,
you know. And the way her clarity is. Exactly, sir. Exactly. And wahi hai, sir. Wahi, that is the tradition of being a Fauji family. It goes into blood, you know, it goes into blood. And so proud to see you in person, because you know, generally we had spoken only, and thanks to sir.
And such a great day to meet you.
We are celebrating his life. He would have been 53 years old today. He would have commanded a brigade. He would have commanded a brigade by now. How much has changed? Huh? Oh my God!
Exactly.
And reading these letters and. You know, everything in this book, and the book has been made by her, by Aprajita. Type out the where can they buy this book, Aprajita, in the and pin it.
I'll do that. I'll type it out and I'll pin it by the end of this talk. So
you pin it and send me this thing. I'll share it on my story, and Vijay and all will all share it. So more and more young people must have this book in their library. You know,
there is no publisher. There is a publisher for this book, because we did not want any percentage of it to go as profit. So what we did was, we have a foundation called the Major Acharya Foundation, and all the proceeds that go to the book go into that foundation. It is a registered trust. So we do charity from that organization.
Okay. That's very good. That's fantastic.
That is wonderful.
So we need to generate more interest in his life. And as it is, this is a Kargil month. And I've been contemplating ki a few people I want to share. Today is, of course, my personal hero. You remember his poster was outside my house. You know, every day I told you, Aprajita.
You told me when you came for walk.
Whenever I walked or took my vehicle from my residence to my office, every day any number of times I saw his poster right in front of my house, you know, very close to my house.
Actually, sir, not only about my father, the thing I admire in all great people, including both of you, is you have this original personality. You're not trying to fit into a mold of something perfect. You embrace your personality and allow it to manifest itself into your specialties. And you take this aspect of yourself. Maybe you do not realize, sir, but when you people talk of running, of cycling, of that kind of, it in a way inspires people that there is no time to stop. When, sir, you continuously study and you go achieving and you write so much, it inspires people because you allow your personality to manifest itself. And that is, I think, a fantastic thing. Because that individuality is there. You're not trying to be perfect in any aspect.
Yeah, absolutely. We also have Ashutosh Sharma's brother. Let me see if I can get him on the video. Another great guy, I want to do a separate show for him, is Colonel Ashutosh Sharma, Brigade of the Guards. Very rare Indian Army has lost CO in combat. Very rare. I think maybe half a dozen since in last 70 years, commanding officers, beyond the very, very few. So he's one of the commanding officers who, sacrificed life in counterinsurgency as commanding officer of 21 3 Sena medals to his name. So his brother is here. I'll try and take him, but I'm going to do a special show for him also, like this, just to discuss his life.
Yeah, Uncle, but tell me something. You were there around that time. You tell me. So everybody knew that it was more or less like almost a suicide mission. They knew they did not have strategic advantage. So there would be loss of life even before the operations began, right? Then yes. How do you motivate people when all of them are intelligent enough to know that there are very high chances of losing life, that the risk is so extraordinary and it's beyond what is regularly, like they know there is going to be loss of life. How do you motivate people in a situation like that? And, when you know that this is it.
See, yahan pe aati hai Paltan ki izzat. There must be so many people at fault for allowing Pakistan to come in so many kilometers inside our line of control. So many kilometers inside, and we had no idea. We had just no idea. And finally, it was sometimes in May, we came to know little bit ki kuch log hain. We said, 7 din mein hata denge, 10 din mein hata denge, kuch nahi hai ye wo. But the entire picture built up by end May, that, so much of intrusion has taken place all over Dras, Kargil, Batalik sector, which is far away, much tougher than Dras, much tougher. Batalik area is really very tough terrain. So there, at that time, it is just chance which unit gets the role, and then the commanding officer and the officers of the unit and the traditions of the unit. Fir baat aati hai ki abhi Paltan ki izzat ki baat hai. Aur Paltan ki izzat bade saalon mein kamai jaati hai. Bahut saal lagte hain. Girane mein ek event lagti hai Paltan ko na mitti mein milane mein. Ek event, ek case ho jaye, Paltan pe dhabba lag jata hai aur wo milta nahi hai saalon saal. To aur iska opposite hai. लड़ाई में जाने का मौका मिलता है, फिर हम भूल जाते हैं कि एडवांटेज है नहीं है, अभी ये टास्क मिला है और ये ऑब्जेक्टिव है और हमने कैप्चर करना है। फिर वो करनी माता की पूजा करके उसके नाम पे सबके सब कफन बांध के चल पड़ते हैं कि यार देखी जाएगी अब क्या होगा। एंड दीज आर ऑल ऑफिसर लेड, इफ देयर इज नो ऑफिसर, इवन इफ द प्लेटून गोइंग, इवन इफ अ सेक्शन वॉज गोइंग इन कारगिल, देयर वर ऑफिसर्स लीडिंग। दैट इज व्हाई वी हैड सो मेनी ऑफिसर कैजुअलिटीज। Imagine the ratio. Unit mein 800-900 jawan hote hain, 4 officers killed. It's very high.
Leading from the front.
That is the quality and of Indian Army, Indian Armed Forces.
They did not complain. They did not complain about acclimatization ka time nahi mila. Equipment is not suited for the climate. They just went. And I think that is such a spirit.
They just went.
Tololing
took quite some time to capture. It took quite some time, and for some time they were just behind boulders pure din upar kahin pe atke hue hain ki raat hogi to aage chalenge. Wahan pe pura Pakistan artillery at that stage was able to take pinpoint shots on the Dras road, on the highway, and this entire thing they could see, because they had their observation posts all over the ridge line. They were dominating, and we were starting from ground below. And inch by inch, capturing, recapturing this post. Of course, a lot of support from our own artillery, you know, Air Force and all that. But Sirbi, you know, very tough area, very, very, very tough area. Wars are not fought in such altitude and in such temperature conditions. And you've been there, you've seen Tololing, how difficult it is.
So, it was the first time when I went, I only read it in books. And only when I went for the first time did I realize, oh, so when they are saying for kilometers down, there is nothing to hide behind. You can, it's just plain rock, huge like mountains of rock. And then I understood, oh, this is like the strategic difficulty. This is the problem that they face. It kind of came in. And when they say they started over here from that point, and it was, then I learned that that place itself.
Units were brought in from other places. Units were brought in from another places. You know, they were not there, destined to fight this war. They were at some other place. Then they were moved in. Entire division was moved in there now to sort out the Pakistani intrusion. So this is, this is really a different kind of war. I hope more people read about it in times to come. And Vijay, you're a naval guy. You know, have you been to the mountains? How do you relate it to the entire thing?
So, coming back to that question, you know, like how you motivate, your men when you know it's like, as she said, it's like more or less like a suicide mission, you know. So that is the difference when everyone asks me, like, what is the definition of motivation? What happens leadership? So when you are in academies, when you undergo those punishments, when you are rolling in gutters and doing that, that is how you are, that is how you are molded into that. And if you see right from the day one in Kargil, when Saurabh went, Saurabh is my batchmate, sir, so batch equivalent.
Okay.
And Saurabh went first, starting from Saurabh, then we had Vijayant was there, and sir was there, and many such things. Because they had this strategic advantage of being on the top, and they were kilometers and kilometers inside. And when you say in corporate, no, like now I've been in corporate for 12 years plus, what is leadership? You know, what is leadership? So leadership, the true leadership, when you know that there is certain, it's like 80-20 percentage, you know, we call Pareto's rule. 20% ye hai ki you are not going to come back, and 80% is you are going to kill. So there is no way that na there is a ray of hope going. Jain sir, Jain Piyush sir,
Jain,
so Piyush, Jain. This is rare.
Good evening,
this
sir. Exactly,
rare.
Sir, exactly.
Aparajita, child of destiny, and here we have brother of Ashutosh Sharma. Wow, what a day. This is incredible.
I was getting goosebumps, sir. I was getting goosebumps, sir. Wonderful to see all in one frame.
So that is what, so when we say leadership and motivation, so that motivation, when you say to your people, na upar jaake marna hai, and when people, like when I was last year, when I was talking to Captain Naveen Nagappa, Naveen sir was with Vikram Batra, Captain Batra. So okay, he was telling, you know, every time you know Kina, there is chances of survival is very less, still that josh and that motivation, and that is how a leadership is, it is born and it is inculcated. And same with Yashmore sir, though, he's experienced and he had seen it close quarter. Colonel Ashutosh, three Sena medals. It's rare and rare in the history of Indian Armed Forces.
You know, he was a Lieutenant Colonel Ashutosh when I was a brigadier in Bhopal in the same corps headquarter. And being a guardsman, I first day itself, there's a regiment, I met him. Arey Ashutosh, tu kya kar raha hai ye wo? Got him home and we met. And then after a few months, and we used to keep meeting in the corridor. I used to cross his office every day. And a Lieutenant Colonel to a Brigadier is a, huge. He was G1 all the time working. He was in G branch. And then one day he tells me, sir, main na 21 RR ja raha hu. Oh, maine kaha, very good. I can never forget that day. Maine kaha, this is going to be excellent. He's going to 21RR. You know, much before he became CEO. So he went there as a company commander. And I briefed him because main tab tak RR kar chuka tha. I knew the entire dynamics. And फिर उसका मुझे खबर लगी कि नेक्स्ट ईयर गॉट अ सेना मेडल. आई कंग्रेचुलेटेड हिम, आई स्पोक टू हिम. उसके बाद वो ही केम बैक फॉर अ ईयर एंड अगेन वेंट बैक टू कमांड द यूनिट इन द सेम प्लेस. व्हेन ही वाज कमांडिंग द यूनिट आई वाज इन ले अपराजिता एंड आई कॉल्ड हिम अप कि यार मैं कश्मीर आ रहा हूँ, आई डोंट नो वेदर आई कैन विजिट द यूनिट. एंड सो मेनी टाइम्स ही कॉल्ड मी कि सर प्लीज यूनिट में आ जाओ, एक बार यूनिट में आ जाओ मेरी कमांड में. अनफॉर्चुनेटली आई कुड नॉट विजिट हिज यूनिट व्हेन ही वाज देयर. And then we hear, his actions and incredible. Piyush, aisa bhai hona bhi yaar, ye bhi koi.
I know, sir.
Aise shakhs ke bhai hona ya brother hona ya beta beti hona ya parents hona ya dost hona, ye
you know. Thank you so much, sir.
Badi kismat ki baat. Aaj hum log ki baat kar rahe hain.
In fact, I was so touched other day when Piyush sir called me, because sorry to reveal it, sir, but generally sir,
बोलते थे कि sir also knows it actually.
12 बजे he speaks to Ashutosh, so I can take that liberty of calling Ashutosh because एक साल Ashutosh was junior to me by in the service. So Piyush sir मुझे वो time पे call किए and then he was like I generally speak to Ashutosh at this time, so today I thought I'll speak to you karke. So it was such a great privilege and being there, and I could be there for that much of time. And it's a bolte na wo aisa rishta hai sir, faujiyon ka hi rishta hota hai, when maybe Aparajita is a, she's a family, and Piyush sir is a family, and it's a bond, it's a bond which
इतिहास लिख के चले गए ना. अभी देखो दे हैव गॉन, इट्स अ फैक्ट. टुडे वी आर सेलिब्रेटिंग देयर लाइफ टाइम्स, द स्टोरीज, देयर यूनिफॉर्म, उनकी पूरी जिंदगी की हम बात कर रहे हैं. बट इमेजिन करो नेक्स्ट जनरेशन कितने प्राउड फील करेंगे यार, ये इनके बच्चे, इनकी 7 पीढ़ियां इस बात का ना गर्व महसूस करेंगे कि यार हमारे घर में वी हैड अ हीरो इन आवर फैमिली.
वी हैड अ हीरो 12th में आया है और उसने एनडीए का फॉर्म भर दिया है. वो पहले से ही बनना चाहता था बट अभी उसने पहला फॉर्म अपना एनडीए का भर दिया है. ही इज प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर डिफेंस.
उसको 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 मेरी रिस्पांसिबिलिटी है उसको मेंटोर करना और उसको ब्रिगेड ऑफ द गार्ड्स में लेके आना.
थैंक यू सो मच. अभी आपने जस्ट जो 2 घंटे पहले जो वीडियो डाला मैंने उसको शेयर कर दिया. वो जिम में था, एक्सरसाइज कर रहा था, तो मैंने जस्ट शेयर कर दिया. अभी आपका वीडियो कॉम्पिटिशन एंड कंपेरिजन पे.
एंड एक लेटर में अपराजिता, your father writes that if son is born, अगर मेरा बेटा हुआ तो 2 राजनीति ज्वाइन करेगा. इमेजिन he's writing from off Vijay this letter कि अगर बेटा हुआ, and he uses the word Mowgli.
Yes, he called me Mowgli and he used to call me Mowgli, and coincidentally the first movie I ever saw was Jungle Book. The first award I ever won was in Fancy Dress, being Balu the Bear from Jungle Book. So that story has some connection.
ये जन्मों का रिश्ता है और ये this is a blood relationship. It goes beyond anything. Everything fails इसके आगे जो है ना, the kind of discussion we are having and the kind of Aparajita, what a pleasure to see you, beta. And to remain in touch with you. And Piyush, what a pleasure to see you.
Sir, अभी आप letters का कह रहे थे, these letters I am carrying of Ashutosh. जो आप कह रहे थे exactly उसी तरह के letter आशु के हैं. You can see the mechanized infantry. He wrote from Ethiopia when he was on UN mission. And these are the letters from OTA.
Oh, so he's also from short service.
Yes, sir, 72 batch. SS-72.
I am SS-38.
I could... OTS, you were telling.
Yeah, that's why I use the word OTS. Because our time pe OTS hota
hai. I know, sir. So he was SS-72.
So he was 72 fact, and apna Archie was which batch, Aparajita?
He was 56.
SS-56. Chappan. Because 93 August he got commissioned. I joined in October 83.
So you can see the guards.
Yeah, I can see them.
So all the letters I have kept.
I am SS 68 equivalent, sir. So that is the.
So that is 30.
In fact, we like, you know, when we are speaking about letters, I still remember. So you know, like it gives you so much of goosebumps. Maybe this generation will miss that handwritten letter.
Exactly.
I still remember, sir, waiting for that letter in academy. घर से जो letter आता था, you know, like. My now wife, पहले she used to be my girlfriend. तो ये जब letter, when that, to wait for that letter in academy, was so nostalgic. Even if you remember today, and one finals letter I remember was you know, sir, like when we were told that we are off Karachi, we are going to Karachi for the Operation Talwar. I was a sub lieutenant, you know, just picking up my first appointment. Rather, it was a training rather than anything. And then you are given this the last letter before you go to the war. You have to write a letter and deposit in the ship's thing, and then it goes to the FMO, sir, Fleet Mail Office. And that 10 minutes which you get to write, probably there is no emotional moment in your life which will come. That 10 minutes was so valuable. Because yeah, you are not knowing whether you are going to come back or not, and that 10 minutes depict everything. So if you're gone, if you in war, if you fall in war, that letter goes to your family, and if not, so ye ho jata, itihas ho jata, they don't let you know that. अभी के generation हम miss कर देंगे सर, ये जो letter, WhatsApp, ये सब इस WhatsApp
में हो जाएगा. Maybe they left something else. They have अब क्या हो गया ना? They all have very good cameras, mobile phones. So they leave a lot of memories of the videos and the. Abhi hume bada dukh hota hai hamare jo hum intense operation the Punjab mein ya J&K. We don't have good quality pictures. We don't have. Otherwise, we would have shot some films. You know,
exactly.
Matlab wo hamari ek drawer hoti. So ye kahin na kahin kuch na kuch har generation ke paas hai jo ki.
In fact, one more funny thing, so Coastmates. So Coastmates, jo hote hai na, sir, they are the most notorious characters. Like each of us have that Coastmate. So I remember for Operation Talwar, luckily or unluckily, like five of us were part of, we were selected for the ships, and rest of our Coastmates were posted elsewhere for that thing. So when we came back after Operation Talwar and, when the war ended, so Coastmates were the first thing. बोलता रे नालायक हो तुम लोग ऐसे ही शहीद हुए बिना आ गए अब हम लोग क्या बोलेंगे लोगों को अगर तुम मर गए होते तो बोल तो सकते कि ना मेरा Coastmate चला गया करके
you know they say on Coastmates ना फौज में कहते हैं they are very good friends मतलब they'll do anything for you दारू पियेंगे उल्टे काम करेंगे they'll hide for you they will give attendance for you they will sacrifice anything for you till you reach a certain rank. After that, your biggest enemies are your Coastmates because appointments are so few. then you are cutting each other because after brigadier rank, there are very few guys. So you are trying to find faults. Ki yaar, ye reh jaa, main upar chale jaa. So best of enemies, best of friends become worst of enemies later on in life.
And it's so tough competing with people who know you in and out. They know your strengths, exactly. They know your weaknesses, exactly. They are seeing you through.
So they'll quote something you did in bio course, some badmashi you did in some course, you know, in Nagar or some place Mau mein. Koi kahani, sabki koi na koi kahani hai.
In fact, sir, my Coastmate doesn't believe even aaj tak that I run marathons and ultra marathons. Wo bolta hai academy mein to sabse piche hua karta tha. We still doubt that you run karke, you know.
वो image वही है, ना पुरानी image लेके चलते हैं वो. जैसे मैं military school से हूँ, तो many of my classmates think यार मैं I was backbencher in class. मतलब मैं बड़ी मुश्किल से 10th pass किया है, बड़ी मुश्किल से I was weak in, you know, I was almost the last 4-5 में था. अब उनको हैरान है यार तूने PhD भी कर ली है, you are a doctor now, तूने MPhil भी कर ली है.
You have 3 masters, sir.
Yeah, मैं कहाँ अभी भी पढ़ रहा हूँ, अभी भी बुक्स लिख रहा हूँ, कुछ ना कुछ कर रहा हूँ, दे आर क्वाइट सरप्राइज. सो लाइफ में ना वी ऑल चेंज, चेंज विद टाइम्स एंड चेंज विद आवर एक्सपीरियंस. किस यूनिट में गए, क्या एक्सपीरियंस मिला वहां पे, कौन अच्छे मेंटोर मिल गया आपको, किसने आपको गाइड कर दिया, बहुत फर्क पड़ता है. बहुत यू आर रॉ when you join as a second lieutenant, any unit could be good or bad, depends on who you meet there and you know kind of environment you get.
You know something, uncle, when Vijay uncle spoke about running, my father actually hated sports. He hated traveling, he hated adventure. Apart from work, if given a chance, he would sit at home, read books, drown himself in a lot of other things. Like as a person, it was not the things he liked, it was the things he had this for the job, you have to do it, okay, do, and that's it. But his passions were so...
I'm so grateful to, you know, Desh, both Adrija and Ansuya for connecting to, you know, various families, in fact. That's how I got connected to, in fact, Colonel Ashutosh family, in fact, Uprise, and so many other people. So they are one pioneers who are doing a great job. So
also, Uncle, when you say that, all of us have somewhere a bias, right? I mean, when you people are, you know, you people are from the system, you are officers on your own, there's a different kind of patriotism. I come from this family, dad is who he is, so it's different. But for them to come from some such various backgrounds, do their regular jobs, you know, take care of their families, yet every day they take out time to reach out to a martyr's family. They've constantly been in touch, celebrate every occasion and tell the stories to others, you know, constantly post about it. It's so much commitment and inspiration. We somewhere have a bias to do what we do. But when they go out of their way to do it, that is truly inspiration.
Exactly. Absolutely. One day we must get them on a live show and talk to them. Where do they get this fire, you know, this passion? Absolutely.
Absolutely.
So it's been a great time. Aparajita, thank you so much. Lots of love and affection for you all the time. Okay, stay in touch and may you have, you know, you fulfill all the desires, all the passion, everything that your father ever thought of you.
Thank you so much, Uncle. Thank you for giving me this wonderful opportunity and I met such wonderful people today. What a day it is.
थैंक यू सो मच.
21
जून को कोई सितारों का मेल हुआ था तभी फादर वॉज बॉर्न. सेलिब्रेटिंग बुक एंड हाँ ये मुझे जरूर पिंग करना, मुझे भी विजय को सबको, एंड लेट सेल यू नो लेट पीपल बाय दिस. इट्स एन अमेजिंग कॉफी टेबल बुक. बहुत ही अगर इसमें पढ़ के अगर आप आपकी आंखें नम नहीं हुई तो फिर आप हिंदुस्तानी नहीं हो सकते.
थैंक यू सो मच, दैट मींस सो मच टू मी. आई विल डेफिनेटली शेयर द डिटेल्स एंड एनीबॉडी हु पिक्स इट अप, यू आर कंट्रीब्यूटिंग टू अ कॉज बिकॉज़ इट गोस टू द फाउंडेशन एंड इट रीचेस पीपल. सो दैट इज One thing you would have loved to.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Vijay, for joining.
God bless you, sir. Vijay Pradhar.
Thank you so much. It's a great session. Really, love you all. Bahut maza aaya.
Thank you.
Wonderful. Jai Hind. Thank you. Jai Hind to, you know, Arti. And, you know, wherever he is, he must be smiling today. He should cut, we all should, you know, celebrate his life and times.
Yes.